You have this video where Salman Khan snatches the phone from a fan over unsolicited selfie. If you watch the video, Salman Khan is walking out. This, you know, ordinary fan, he's like, Salman Khan. Hey, everyone, look, Salman Khan. Hey, he takes a selfie, photograph a video. Salman Khan sees this, grabs the phone, walks off, you know, like big guy with his bodyguards. And the poor guy doesn't know what the fuck to do. I don't know if he got his phone back. Now, what do I think about this? This is what the expat or follower or whatever wanted to know. Number one is the guy who has a phone. It's his phone. He can take a selfie. That's his wish. His phone he is holding. Okay, whatever. Okay. Is it rude? Yes, it's rude. Is it common? Yes, it's common. You can't help it. Today's day and age, everyone has a phone. Everyone likes to take a selfie. If you actually see John Cena, when he was ordering food, there was this YouTuber who is a Muslim chap, a British guy. He likes to stir up a little bit of controversy. So he was busy taking a selfie with John Cena, and John Cena knew that he was taking, and John Cena told him not to do, but he still continued. So this is a commonplace. Okay, people have done it even with me. Even when I'm running, they take their video and they follow me. I'm used to it. Okay. So Salman Khan, I'm pretty sure, is used to it. However, the only difference is in this, he reacted. And not only reacted, it was captured by the media. Now, did what Salman Khan did, is it wrong? Yes, it's wrong. You're not supposed to touch someone. You're not supposed to take their stuff. You're not supposed to harm anyone or bully anyone. That's the first thing. The second thing is, being a celebrity or being on social media or being so visible, you have a certain amount of responsibility to hold yourself in a certain regard. It's a lot of fucking pressure. It's not easy. People harass you left, right, and center, and you're in the spotlight 24/7. So it becomes suffocating. So maybe Salman Khan had a bad day. Maybe he was just not in a mood. So you can't expect him to be goody-goody all the while. So as a human being, you tend to have bad days as well. So I think Salman Khan had a bad day. Now, what would I say? I would just say that Salman Khan should apologize, because that is not called for. That's number one. Second thing is, you can't go around, controlling the whole world, because you'll have 10,000 fans tomorrow. What are you going to do? Beat up all the 10,000? No. You're a celebrity. You're known. People will want to do it. People want to take your photograph. They want to do all this. But just relax the fuck out. That's what I would say. So I don't blame the guy. He's in the spotlight 24/7. Sometimes it can be a really, really tedious, tiresome task. I would just say that, damage control. That's what I would recommend to Salman Khan. Next one. This one was sent, Arnab, that guy, I'm not a fan of his stuff. I've just seen one or two YouTube videos. So this guy, for those of you who don't know, is a political, host, where he's not a journalist by any standards. He researches kind of hot topics, hot buttons, and he speaks on them. There is a tendency for him to support political parties. So he justifies whatever they do, which is normal in every country. Like in US, CNN might support one political party, Fox News another one. There are Republicans, there are Democrats. In the same way, in India, there are people who support either BJP or Congress. So Arnab, I assume, supports the BJP. Okay, so he gets a lot of favors, political clout. He gets a lot of benefits by doing that. Now, if you see his sessions, they're nothing but shouting sessions. Okay, the debates are, oh, don't you dare talk to my panelists. Don't you dare talk to blah, 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 blah. Oof, fucking hell. It's like they bring four, five, six people, and everyone's in a shouting fucking match. It's like whoever shouts the loudest or whoever keeps shouting, I don't understand what the fuck is what anyone's saying. You just don't fucking understand what anyone is saying. There is nothing worthwhile that comes. It's just like entertainment, senseless entertainment, where it's like a screaming contest. So this guy, Arnab, always takes on hot button topics. and he has a view. He has a particular view and he tries to sell a particular point. So I do not know what was a particular thing that this comedian tried to get him, catch him red-handed on. So he asked Arnab the same question what Arnab had apparently asked some other people. So he asked Arnab, and he was trying to get him to respond. But Arnab took his laptop and he kept quiet. He didn't say a word. Okay, so he was saying, "Ah, are you a coward? Oh, speak the fuck up," or some shit he said, and Arnab kept quiet. Now, given the fact that Arnab is not very popular, a lot of his haters kind of shared it, and he's like, "Oh, he's a fucking coward, he's this, he's that." So one of them sent me this video and asked me, what was my view on this? I would just tell you that Arnab is, he plays his part pretty well. He is a smart businessman. He's marketing a particular image. He's marketing a particular brand. Like Shah Rukh Khan shows, he's a very romantic hero. John Abraham, Akshay Kumar, Khanna, whatever. They show that they're heroes. Then you have the bad guys who show that they're villains. You have females who show that they are sexy. Arnab likes to show that he is a political host or debater who supports a particular point of view. Now, majority of people tune in for the drama. And yes, there are many people who hate him, but he gets viewers, he gets eyeballs, he gets attention, and he generates a lot of revenue to these businesses. And that's what matters in the end. He makes them a lot of money, he makes a lot of money. In the end, they are the winners. The people who react, who give him the attention, they are the fucking losers. And in this, the guy who tried to instigate him might be seen as a hero. Well, he's, you know, practicing his right to state an opinion. Great. He will be applauded as a hero by people who do not like Arnab. Great. Okay. But has Arnab lost anything? I don't think so. I think he has got much more free publicity because of this incident, and he's going to continue being famous. So they will continue doing what they have to do. They just want you to react, and that's exactly what you're doing. So in the end, who is the winner? According to me, Arnab is the winner. The guy who instigated, short-term winner, yes, he got the attention, but eventually people are going to forget about him and focus on Arnab once again. So this is what I think. Let me know what you think. And last, if not the least, is Priyanka Chopra. Now, Priyanka Chopra, not seen any movie of hers, don't know much about her, apart from the fact that she is a famous actress. Now, she decided to walk this red carpet, you know, having this dress whereby she's not wearing a bra, she shows herself right from the center all the way to the navel, and, you know, everyone was talking about it. She was with her husband, Johansson, or whatever his name is. Okay. I'm not very much in the celebrity scene, but people want to know, what do I think? Now, let's understand this. Who is Priyanka Chopra? She's a celebrity. She's a star. How does she prove her relevance? By being in the spotlight. And either she can do it through movies or she can do it through social media. Now, when any celebrity star wants to be noticed, wants free publicity, they tend to do something shocking or another. And during these red carpet moments is where celebrity stars try to do something which will make everyone speak about them. You remember Labov, whatever the fuck his name is, the Transformers guy, he had a brown paper bag on his head. Why did he do it? And he put that, "I'm not famous," or some shit like that. Why did he do it? For attention. Do they do it normally? They never do it normally. They do it there for free publicity. Why do you think some superstars or celebrity stars wear see-through dresses where they show their ass, they show their boobs, they show their, you know, different parts of their body? Why? Why do men dress up like women wearing a skirt? Why do some guys wear pink or ridiculous stuff or have holes here and something hanging here? And why do they put all this? Do they put it in a normal day-to-day setting? No. They put it there because they know the media will just swallow it up and give them the free publicity that they need. So that's the only place where they can get free mileage. So they will do whatever it takes to get the mileage. What do I think of it? I'm not very much a fan of seeing all this. For me, if I have to see all this, I might as well go to Pornhub. Okay. Is it beautiful? I didn't think it suited her. I feel Priyanka Chopra looks beautiful as an Indian woman dressed up in a sari. That's my at least my opinion. I don't think she looks very nice in that dress. She was compared to Jennifer Lopez and this Indian, online website said that she was trying to copy Jennifer Lopez, and she is nowhere compared to them. Well, you can't help it when people compare things. Obviously, Jennifer Lopez was the first one who did. Yes, she did look amazing. Priyanka Chopra, and especially when she has this, you know, flabby part of the skin and all that. So, but it's okay. It's her body. Now, does it show women's empowerment? There's nothing empowering about showing your boobs, your vagina, and your hole, and this and that. If that was women's empowerment, if I show my penis, it should be men's empowerment. There's nothing empowering about showing yourself naked. It's normal. It's natural. Okay? She feels that she's empowering people by being naked. Fine. And people talking about, oh, don't objectify us. Well, you walk around naked showing your objects. Well, we will comment on that. If I go around showing my crotch to other people and saying, you know, you shouldn't look at my sexual parts, all that, that's fucking rubbish. Okay? Whether you want to roam about naked or put clothes or whatever, that's up to you. For me personally, I would always, I'm more comfortable. Let's put it that way. I'm more comfortable with my wife, me, and my baby wearing clothes. I don't think I'd be very comfortable if my daughter were to show her body. But then again, after she grows to a certain age, she can show her body. If my wife chooses to look sexy and she wants to wear that, you can go ahead and wear that. For me, I'm comfortable with this. Like, you know, I put tattoos on my face. It's comfortable to me. When I go running only with my shorts. Running trunks. Nothing at the top. So that's my body. Like I say, you're grown up. You do whatever the fuck you want. Okay? And for those people who get, oh, wow, boobs and vagina and this and that. Listen, man. I don't know when you'll grow the fuck up from being a 13-year-old. When you're 13 and you see nipples and you see a vagina and you see a penis, grow the fuck up. It's just a fucking nipple. It's just a fucking vagina. It's just a fucking penis. Whatever. Those are body parts. Just as when you see your, if you see your mother naked or if you see your father naked, let's say they are hospitalized, they are lying down there and you need to maybe clean their shit or you need to clean their private parts. You're not going to get, wow, vagina, wow, boobs. No, that's your mother, father. It's all in the head. So when you see a body part, it's all in the head. Okay? When I see my daughter, when I see my wife, I don't say, wow. No. It's my family. So in the same way, you need to grow the fuck up if you still get turned on by seeing a body part. You really need to grow the fuck up, okay? That's my opinion. Let me know what you think. And the funny thing is, people are talking more about this and less about the fact that she has, she's in talks for Matrix 4, which I think should be talked about more. But we live in a world where you show your body parts, people talk about them. That's why. Why do you think Kim Kardashian is famous? I don't think it's for her values or for her teaching about God. Anyway.